He leaned in for a kiss and pooped his pants. At the same time? Ew! No! Seriously, these stories really make me feel like so grateful that I don't have to be single anymore. I just don't have to deal with the dating pool for the rest of my life, hopefully. Pooping your pants on a first date is a pretty fearless move. No, it's not. It's gross. You're not getting a call back until you go get some wipes and take care of your business down there. Is he just not gonna wear pants for the rest of the date? What if you're out at a restaurant? I would ditch him. Like, as soon as he goes to the bathroom to clean up, I'm gone. You grab the tip that he left on the table and dip. Just yeet yourself out the restaurant. Right out the window. I met up with a guy at a bar. That's always fun. It was like pulling teeth to talk with him. Ugh. It's already hard enough to come up with conversation topics with new people. If they can't contribute anything back, then it's hopeless. I try to talk about travel, and he says, I don't see why anyone would ever want to leave the US. Ugh, I already know what kind of guy this is. Ew, girl, run. I try to talk about running.
I don't know why people run for fun.
Probably because you're too fat. Finally, he contributes something as he says he likes cars. Ew. Like, I love cars, but guys who are super into cars, they always mansplain car stuff to girls like we're kindergartners. So I tell him about how my brother just purchased an Aston Martin.
Oh, Aston Martins are crap. I really only like Camaros.
And I tell him I drove an old Camaro for 9 years.
You don't know crap about cars.
See? What'd I tell you? And she's like, okay, I don't. I'm not gonna deny that, but really, all I said was I drove a Camaro from 16 to 25. Like, I never said I was an expert, and why are you trying to make me feel bad about not being a car expert? I bet he doesn't know anything either. He just drove one. Guys, I'm telling you right now, this is not the way to get a girl to like you. You're not impressing her. You're annoying her. You're being rude. His apartment was filled with blood-stained pillowcases. What? How do you explain this? Went back to his place, presumably for stuff. The pillowcases were stained with blood. Place was filled with empty beer cans. Four, I kid you not, four rusty hair-filled razors in the shower. All of them were his. The sink was coated in hair and toothpaste. I was so disturbed. Then he told me he had a suspended license and a kid he never met. And I hightailed it home. Girl, get out of there. That's a murderer. Why is his license suspended, huh? I went on 2 dates with a guy where conversation was like getting blood from a stone. But I was lonely and lived in a small town. That's always hard. Don't date in your own town. Second date, he drove and drank a lot, seemingly on purpose so he wouldn't be able to drive home. This was before Uber and Lyft, and he begged to share a cab with me to go back to my place. I agreed, and he spent the whole night crying in my bed about how I was going to leave him. Dude, you need to calm down. I broke it off. He then looked up a performance I was in later that year in college and showed up. When the show ended, he waited around to say hi, and then interrupted me while I greeted people to say, "So that's why you've been so busy," and then stormed out. He drove 35 minutes and sat through a 90-minute play just for that. Dude, you need to calm down. You got issues. I'm not down with this clinginess. He mansplained. Gross. Nope. Went to grab dinner. He comments on me ordering pizza in an Italian restaurant. Dude, let her order what she wants. Why are you pressed? He comments on me eating pizza with a knife and a fork. Okay, I feel like that's extra, but at the same time, I understand it. You don't want to get your hands messy? Leave her alone. He comments on me not wearing enough makeup. No. No. Only thing you should say to a girl is, you look beautiful. Don't comment on how much or how little makeup she has on at all. Trust me. I politely ask about his work, and he explains what he does as if he's talking to a 4-year-old. Even though he knows I'm doing 2 master degrees and did biology at my finals. She's smarter than you, bro. He's overcompensating and trying to seem like he knows more than you when he doesn't. Throughout the date, he kept explaining stuff to me as if I'm in kindergarten. Doesn't ask me anything about myself, just has these long monologues about himself. I decline getting another drink and leave. Dodge his kiss, give him a peck on the cheek, and on my way home, I get a text asking if I'm sure I don't want that kiss. Yeah, I'm pretty dang sure. Bye. After I ordered my coffee, he immediately asked if I'd watch a quick video on his laptop while I waited. It was a 12-minute long video about his multi-level marketing vacation club that was totally not a pyramid scheme. Is this a date or an interview? Dude, Not the time and place. Guys, if a Facebook mom ever messages you about that over the Facebook Messenger thingy, don't do it. He was openly sexist. Ugh. How are you proud of that? Go back to the South. One guy casually told me that women need to be escorted to the grocery store so that they keep their eye on the prize and don't spend like $200 on random things. Those were his actual words. Then he proceeded to explain why he was right about this and why it's not offensive when I told him I did not appreciate his statement. You really have the audacity to tell me, no, you're not offended, you're wrong, I'm right. Stop. Then he told me about his years of psychological and physical abuse by his father, eventually culminating in him being stabbed by his father. He also suggested I listen to a couple of his favorite podcasts by a Trump-supporting, feminist-hating misogynist. Okay, dude. On the way home, I gave him a ride because it was cold out and apparently I'm a bleeding heart. Good for you, you're being polite. When you didn't even have to. He asked me if I would go on a 14-hour road trip that weekend with him, which would have been our second date. Hard no. Like, were you not on the date that we were just on? Girls, do not go on road trips until it's been at least a few months and you really know them. And you can trust them that, you know, they won't murder you. I met up with this girl. We went to a bar for some drinks. And we seemed to be really hitting it off. And then her boyfriend turns up. It turns out he wanted to have a male-female-female threesome. And they had a Tinder account for her in order to find someone. You don't trick someone into it. You at least make a couple's account and you say you're looking for that specific thing. You don't trick someone into coming to a date. When I got annoyed by this, they both got really aggressive. And they followed me out of the bar and tried to get in the taxi with me. No. Disloyal mouse, get out of there. These usernames are interesting. He just seemed not all there. While we were at the bar, he kept asking me to explain what some of the words I was using meant. He refused to take off his coat and awkwardly started swearing. This guy seems off. He would ask me to come back to his place each time I finished a sip of my drink. He's literally waiting until you get drunk enough to take advantage of you. Are you serious? The next day, I told him I wasn't interested in seeing him anymore. And then he asked me to refund him for the drink I offered to pay for, but he insisted on paying. No. Not giving you $5 for a cocktail. Reddit user triggered Quilt. How can a quilt get triggered? Please tell me. Once upon a time, I went out with a guy who got wine drunk at Olive Garden. That sounds fun, actually, like with your girlfriends. And then in a drunk rage, he punched the windshield out of my car when I offered to drive him home because he was belligerent. Yeah, red flag. Big red flag. A few years back, I got catfished by what had to be a 45-year-old man who lied about being 26. I was 23 and so scared of what would happen that I just didn't say anything. We actually had a pleasant dinner, but I declined every romantic advance and he didn't kill me, so yay! I love how every like heterosexual woman has that same sigh of relief when they realize they're not gonna get murdered by a sketchy dude. It's so sad. Comment below if you even understand what I'm saying. Once I went on a first date with this guy I met online and had talked to for about a month. We met at a restaurant for dinner and that part actually went really well. After dinner, he walks me to my car and then proceeds to tell me that he really likes me, but I need to know that he is actually married with two kids and that he's not looking for just, you know, adult things. He wants a relationship that would remain secret until the kids are 18. I didn't say anything. I just stared at him and then got in my car and left. Don't hate me, but at least he's being honest to somebody. Not his wife, obviously. Just separate from your wife and then go see other people. You can still co-parent together without the romantic relationship if you're responsible. You can work it out if you're a mature adult. Went on a coffee date with a guy whose pupils were dilated the whole time. Is he on drugs? He proudly talked about how he had 11 jobs in 2 years. That's a lot. Because it doesn't suit me to hang around places for too long. Yeah, because everyone kicks you out. Then insinuated he expected me to do things with him in the Starbucks parking lot in 20 degree weather. And then he smelled me. Like, what the heck? Stop it. I was once set up by my grandma with the guy from her church. And it turned out it wasn't a blind date, it was a double date. with my grandparents. Ew. What are we going to the Saturday morning senior breakfast at IHOP? No thanks, Grandma. I mean, pancakes, that doesn't sound too bad actually. But I'm not going to breakfast at 7 a.m. I go to bed at 7 a.m. Well, that's cringy. Sounds fun. But that was fun, so comment below if you have any of your own cringy first date stories. And that's it, so click the screen to watch another video and subscribe and turn on notifications, and I'll see you next time.